first order star destroyer that is now headed to this system. Your outpost on Batuu is no longer safe. We have transports waiting to take you to General Organa's secret base on Pakara. I'll regroup with you there. The Resistance desperately needs your help in our fight against Kylo Ren and the First Order. Remember, it is vital that you keep the location of the Pakara base secret. Lieutenant Beck, one of our top commanders, will lead you.
Affirmative. Transport is ready. 9 number 9 shall personally see them delivered.
Thank you, Lieutenant. Welcome to the cause. May the Force be with us.
Commander Poe Dameron and a squadron of X-Wings shall escort us to the rendezvous point on the car.
Roger, this is Black Leader. I hear you're a fine-looking group of recruits. Well, no time to waste. Let's get you on your way to the General.
Resistance, let's get you out. months while we don't talk about the increasing humidity that comes when they're actually not out. But now that you're here, welcome to the workshop, everyone. We're glad you finally made it. But we also know you went through a lot to get here. So please just take a moment, take a breath, take in the room, because while not everybody gets to see this, this is our everything. And the people around this room are the best people in the galaxy. You will get to meet them for yourself later. In the meantime, you may call me Kembe. But I invited you to look at the room, so I should probably clarify. This looks a lot like old junk, right? Tato, is that you?
No.
Well, that's surprising to hear from Tato because, well, when Tato started at the workshop, all of this was new junk. Well, they like that. They like you a lot, Tato.
Yeah.
They support you. And don't worry, so do I. Don't worry too much because, well, we kind of pick on each other. We're a close-knit group of friends and colleagues that travel the galaxy collecting scrap, relics, history that's left behind. We bring it here so that if a stormtrooper came through the door, they would see a lot of worthless clutter. We see precious history. And speaking of history, I'm sure you've heard the legend of Luke Skywalker, yes?
Yes.
So they do talk. Oh no. Alright, well, we hear there's another. A new Jedi named Rey. And what Rey is leading, it's a spark of hope. A spark of hope that brought you here to build a lightsaber. The lightsaber has been wielded by our greatest heroes. But it's also been wielded by some of our darkest enemies. It is elegant and enigmatic. To build a lightsaber is an art because the lightsaber is a reflection of the builder. The force connects them. You will experience this connection for yourself today. But not if I just keep talking about it. You're barely holding on. Shall we begin?
Yes.
Good. We begin with the Kyber Crystal. The Kyber Crystal has this unique ability to focus the energy of the Force and magnify it. Some call the Kyber Crystal the heart of the lightsaber, because the color of the crystal reveals the color of the blade. I'm sure you've heard of some of these crystals in the greatest Jedi legends in history. Like the Blue Crystal, wielded by Master Obi-Wan Kenobi and his apprentice, Anakin Skywalker. Now it is wielded by Rey. The Green Crystal, Qui-Gon Jinn, Ahsoka Tano, Master Yoda himself, and Luke Skywalker. The Violet Crystal. This one is very rare and very beautiful, just like the one wielded by Master Mace Windu. And Rey. Some call this the color of power. It is wielded by Darth Maul, Asajj Ventress, Darth Vader. Now it is wielded by Kylo Ren. But we are not here for stories of the past. We are here to plan for our future. You. So before you choose your Kyber Crystal, I want you to take a moment.
Now, join me. Yes, lightsaber.
between Saber and Builder will be officially forged. In a moment, I will ask for you to step forward. Then you will place your hand on your hilt, and when I say activate, we will activate together as one. Builder, step forward. Place your hands on your hilts. Activate. Builders, raise your lightsabers. You have created a lightsaber. You are just like the Jedi and the Sith that have come before you. You will change the galaxy just like they did. But remember, Builders, it only takes just a spark. Now, I am a brave woman, but I do have two red crystals next to me, so for my sake, deactivate to lower your saving.
By any way it can, I believe you, it can help. Your journey will be over. May your force be with you.
Thank you, Master Yoda. Friends, in your hands you hold remarkable power. Remarkable power should not be dropped on the ground. Yeah, that's about how I thought that joke would go. So to prevent that, I'm pleased to present to you a saber sheet as you depart today. Builders, raise your lightsabers. You have created a lightsaber. You are just like the Jedi and the Sith that have come before you. You will change the galaxy just like they did. But remember, Builders, it only takes just a spark. Now, I am a brave woman, but I do have two red crystals next to me, so for my sake, deactivate and lower your saber.
Thank you. Slam him.
Storytelling and sing-along, capturing the best of Frozen moments. For the safety of others during our presentation, we ask you to refrain from smoking, eating, drinking, and flash photography. We encourage photos and recording, but please do not obstruct the view of those around you with your smart devices. And please feel free to sing along at the top of your lungs. Thank you.
Just Eric.
Yeah. Thank you, Just Eric. And what a better way to celebrate Arendelle than to have the royal historian share the story of our kingdom and our queen, who just happens to be my sister, Queen Elsa.
Yes! Where is Queen Elsa?
Yes, I have been waiting so long for this moment. I don't know. Have any of you seen my sister? Well, she's about so tall, blonde, kind of keeps to herself. Oh yeah, and she has these cool icy snow powers, like pew, 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 pew. No? Oh, I know. Hey, Elsa, do you want to build a snowman? Yeah, that never really worked.
Oh my,
what are we going to do? It's almost time for the Arendelle Festival and Elsa's missing.
Princess,
and everyone's already here.
Anna.
Oh, almost as bad as a blizzard. Well, almost.
Let's just take a breath here.
Yeah, don't worry. We've got this. You go find your sister and we can share the history of Arendelle.
Yeah. We'll have them singing all the royal anthems, right?
Yeah. Oh, okay, that sounds good. Well, I best be off then to find my sister. I'll be back. Elsa? Elsa?
Oh, Eric, are you ready?
I was born ready.
Okay, here we go. Citizens of the Kingdom of Hollywood Land, we proudly present to you the story of Anna and Elsa. We also cordially invite you to join us in the singing of any of our Arendelle anthems. Just follow along if you don't know the words.
I have a feeling we already know the words.
Okay, where should we start?
Let it go, let it go.
No. We gotta work up to that one.
All right, what were you thinking?
Where every good story starts, the beginning.
It was a dark and stormy night.
No, it wasn't.
It was the best of times, it was the worst of times.
Okay, this is quickly becoming the worst of times.
Help me out.
It was a beautiful day in the kingdom of Arendelle.
Right, that story. There were two sisters. They loved each other very much.
Princess Anna and Princess Elsa.
Princess Elsa was different. She was born with special powers.
Magical powers that created snow and ice. Anna loved playing with Elsa's magical snow.
Till one night when something horrible happened, Princess Elsa created a giant snow monster!
Oh, yeah. Eric, you're jumping ahead again. Let's rewind. You see, Elsa hit Anna with her powers, freezing Anna's head.
And the king and queen, they rush her to the help of the trolls. Now, if you're not sure what a troll is, consider yourself lucky. They're mischievous creatures with strange magic. And frankly, I never liked them.
Why?
One of them rolled over my toe. I'm not a fan of the rock and roll. I'm a little bit country.
Oh my gosh. Would you focus? Grandpappy, king of the trolls, fixed on his head, though he removed all memories of magic.
Wow, that snowman.
And what a nice voice.
Andy loves summertime.
Oh, time! We have to hurry and finish the story.
Let's do this.
Okay. The odd quartet of Anna, Olaf, Sven, and Kristoff make it to Elsa's ice castle on the North Mountain.
Elsa tells Anna to go away and freezes her heart.
Accidentally.
When learning of Arendelle's fate.
Then she sends Marshmallow after them. Anna and Kristoff almost die by jumping off a cliff, but luckily the snow softens their fall.
Let me know that Olaf has no skull or no bones.
I don't have a skull. Or bones.
Anna's hair starts to turn white, so Kristoff takes her to see the love expert.
It was too late. Anna was getting colder by the minute, and as Grandpappy said,
only an act of true love can thaw a frozen heart.
Oh, that part gets me every time.
We gotta go!
So they race back to Arendelle to find Hans so he can melt Anna's heart with a true love's kiss. See, true love.
In the meantime, Hans gets a group of guys to try to capture Elsa. Not a cool move, dude.
No, Kristoff gets Anna to Hans, who leans in to kiss Anna and save the day when...
He laughs in her face.
Hans is the bad guy?
Yes, he leaves Anna in a cold room to freeze to death, all so he can take over the kingdom.
Hans is the bad guy!
Did you sleep through Arendelle History 101?
Oh, no, you do not. Elsa escapes from her prison and tries to run away across the fjord again. But Hans is not pursued. While Olaf comes to Anna's rescue.
He convinces Anna that Kristoff, not Hans, is her true love.
Then, back out in the frozen fjord, Anna runs. No, she shuffles to Kristoff as she starts to freeze. Then she sees Hans about to kill her sister. She's standing there in the blizzard, torn. Does she save herself or her sister? What to do? Eric, what to do?
Alexa, what to do?
Not Alexa, Eric. You're Eric and you have to say what she did.
Olaf to the rescue! Yes, first he takes out Hans' little stick hands and then he kisses Anna.
Wait,
that's right, the talking snowman is the act of true love that can thaw a frozen heart. And everybody lives happily ever after because some
people
are
worth melting for.
The end!
Thank you.
Perfect.
Let's get out of here.
Hello, Anna.
Hi.
Hi, Kristoff.
Hello again.
Have you found your sister yet?
Well, we're still kind of looking for her.
No.
What is going on?
Well, it's getting cold in here, and that can only mean one thing.
Oh, I hope so, that we can really celebrate the Arendelle Festival.
Entire kingdom. It was you who saved your sister and yourself.
An act of true love will thaw a frozen heart.
You're my sister, Elsa. I love you.
Oh, excuse me, Queen Elsa. The citizens of the Kingdom of Hollywood Land did an excellent job singing the Arendelle anthem.
It was almost like they heard the songs before.
You make all of Arendelle very proud. Yes, of course. Thank you, Eric, and you, Aria, the Royal Historians of Arendelle! We're just happy to be of service.
Elsa, today's the Arendelle Festival.
I have the perfect way to help celebrate.
I want you so much for coming!
Great job!
Anna, come on, let's go find Sven!
Thank you all for coming and singing along with us today!
And enjoy the rest of your day exploring!